So earlier in my career, when I was in a university hospital, I once had this time when a patient came in and they were actually a boxer. So I always asked what people do, and this guy was like, well, you know, I was a boxer. And not surprisingly, he came in with a droopy eyelid. So turns out droopy eyelids are actually pretty common in boxers, because if you think about it, if you get punched in the face a whole bunch of times and you get that swelling of the eyelid, you know, black eye over and over and over, that's gonna stretch some of the skin, but it's more importantly gonna stretch that muscle that helps you lift the eyelid. So, super nice guy. I go through my whole spiel. I say, you know, this is the surgery that's gonna help. This is how long the surgery takes. You're gonna be under anesthesia. This is what your recovery is gonna be like. You're gonna have a black eye afterwards. And you know, it's covered by insurance because it's blocking your vision. And at the end of my whole spiel, he looks at me in the eyes and he says, yeah, but can exercise fix this? Eyelid exercise is not gonna fix a droopy eyelid, especially in a boxer. So let's dive into why. Now, I see a lot of stuff online about aerobics for the face, for the eyelids, holding your hands like this, looking up and down and squeezing and things like that. And I understand why that is an attractive idea, because nobody wants surgery. I don't have any patients that come into my office every day and they're like, I really want to have surgery. That's all I want. People want to have their eyelids look better, but they would be very open to anything besides surgery to fix it. And think about it. We've got this boxer here. He's been exercising his whole life. So it makes sense that if I'm telling you that there is a muscle that lifts the eyelid, and I've got these muscles as a boxer that I've trained, why couldn't I train the muscles in my eyelid to work better so that I don't have to have surgery? Makes sense. Here's the problem with that. So when you lift your eyelid, there are a couple things that happen. Number one, your brain gives a signal to the third nerve in your brain and says, I want the eyelid to open and I want to use the muscle that lifts the eyelid. I don't want to use the forehead. I want to use the muscle that lifts the eyelid. What happens is that sends a signal to the muscle, and the muscle is attached to a foot plate. And it's not really a strong muscle. It's a very, very thin muscle. And the muscle kind of is a little bit disconnected from the foot plate, but it has a tendon that is connecting it to the foot plate. That's called the aponeurosis. So think about it like this. If you're trying to lift up a blanket and you're trying to get the frayed edges to fold correctly, you're never gonna be able to get the frayed edges to all align, because there are all kinds of different tendrils and fibers that are coming off the frayed edge of the blanket. That's the part that's attaching to that foot plate of the eyelid. It's not necessarily the muscle itself that's attaching to the foot plate of the eyelid that we are correcting. So this is what I'm trying to say. So this is why eyelid exercises are not gonna necessarily fix a droopy eyelid. When you have a droopy eyelid, fibers that connect that muscle to the foot plate have stretched or torn. And so that's why when your brain sends that signal to open the eye, there's only a limited amount that that foot plate is gonna come up with that muscle. The muscle might be working just fine, but if those fibers connecting the muscle to the foot plate aren't working, that foot plate's not gonna go anywhere, and you're gonna be looking kind of like this, with sort of heavy eyelids covering up half of your vision, or covering up the black dot in your eye called the pupil. So that's what happens when you have a droopy eyelid. So think about that. Strengthening the muscle is not going to fix the droopy eyelid. It's probably not even going to prevent it, because it's that connection between the muscle and that foot plate that causes a droopy eyelid. So if you want to try eyelid exercises, be my guest. They might help you, and they certainly will help you feel better about your face, because you're just focusing on those muscles. But it's not necessarily something that's going to fix a droopy eyelid. Unfortunately, the treatments for droopy eyelid are mainly surgery. Now, there is one treatment you could consider that's not surgery, and that's called apneic. It's an eye drop that you use, and what it does is it stimulates that muscle to contract, kind of putting it on overdrive, as if your bicep was just kind of connected like this at all times, but then you couldn't really move your hand very easily if that was the case. When you have that eye drop in, it will spark up your eyelids to be a little bit higher. Lasts a few hours. Problem is, it's not covered by insurance, and it is a little bit expensive, and so most of my patients choose to have surgery instead. So if you're thinking about eyelid exercises and whether they can help you to fix a droopy eyelid, I would encourage you to think that it's not just the muscle that's the problem, it's the muscle and how it attaches to that foot plate. And no matter what you do, you're not gonna necessarily strengthen that really fine tendinous attachment, because it doesn't have any muscle fibers in it. I hope that's been helpful. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel and check out our other videos on eyelid surgery, or comment below if you have a different opinion about eyelid exercises, or if you found some that I haven't that can fix a droopy eyelid.